Civil society organizations that advocate for rights of girls have come out to decry the unabated upsurge of cases of child marriages and teenage pregnancies in the country. Recent statistics indicate that 34% of ever married Ugandans married before the legal age of 18 years.
Child marriage is a violation of children's rights and has dire consequences like teenage pregnancies, dropping out of school, health complications like fistula, shame, stigma.
Teenage pregnancies in between 11 to 15 years, they are 5 times higher at a risk of dying while giving birth. So this vice should be stopped.
In this regard, the activists have made an outcry to parents to step up protection of children who are back from school for long holidays. They are also calling on the government to establish more shelters where victims of child marriages can seek refuge.
During these holidays, especially the Christmas holidays, we call upon all parents in Uganda and all over the world to protect children from any kind of abuse, sexual abuse, child marriage.
According to the police crime report of 2022, a total of 14,693 sex-related cases were reported, representing 6.3% of other overall registered crimes recorded that year. Now, activists have put Parliament to task to expedite enactment of the Sexual Offences Bill to facilitate explicit handling of cases.
Uganda has laws and policies that describe punishments for child marriage, rape, and defilement. These include the Constitution of the Republic of Uganda, the Penal Code Act, Children's Act, and the Anti-Female Genital Mutilation Act, Anti-Trafficking in Persons Act, and the National Child Policy 2020.
The Parliament of Uganda should prioritize passing of gender-responsive laws like the Sexual Offences Bill, as it provides for a separate offence on child marriage.
The bill was first introduced in 2016 by the then Kumi District Woman Member of Parliament, Monica Amoding, seeking to consolidate laws relating to sexual offences and provide procedural and evidential requirements during trial of sexual cases. Activists claim the Penal Code Act has gaps that don't provide for a separate offence on child marriages.
We have the laws, but they have some gaps. That, for example, relating to the punishments and also description of who a child is, etc. And we have to note again that crime changes, evolves.
The Sexual Offences Bill was passed by the 10th Parliament in 2021, but it was not assented to by the President, who returned it to Parliament. Relatedly, Busoga Kingdom has declared war on teenage pregnancies. In a new operation, parents, religious and cultural leaders engaged in marrying off young girls will be arrested. We are going to start operations of arresting parents, those who are marrying off young girls, and you are hereby warned in advance. Even religious and cultural leaders who conduct these occasions will not be spared, because the Chavazinga wants all the young girls to complete their education. Apofia Nawala, a teenager, attributed the root cause of the problem to failure by parents to provide necessities to their daughters.
I would be in the need of a badge, because some parents, they are harsh and rude. If you go there, that let over mommy, I need some help. I'm in my periods, but I don't have. She will tell you that now what can I do?
Busoga Kingdom is working with a number of stakeholders who have vowed to sensitize the community and identify the victims so as to provide the necessary support.
The younger mothers have been skilled in carrying out research at their level. We continue with this activity of carrying out research, counseling, identifying more mothers, talking to them, building confidence in them.
Research has shown us different girls suffering in different areas, that they can't talk to their parents. But not only that, the relationship between the parents, more so the male side.
Story compiled by Fred Kajubi and Ivan Wakibi for the news.